This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about multiplying decimals. So here's the problem we're dealing with. I've got 5.18 times 4.7. So I'm going to write this as a decimal, as a multiplication problem with one number above the other. I'm going to put the decimal points in, but I'm not going to worry about them for the moment. And now we'll go ahead with my multiplication, again, not worrying about the decimal points. So I've got to multiply 7 times 8, that's 56. I'll write the 6, and I'll be carrying a 5. Then there's 7 times 1 is 7, plus the 5 that I'm carrying is 12. So I'll write the 2 and carry a 1. And then 7 times 5 is 35, plus 1 more is 36. Then I'm going on to multiply by 4. So I'll add a 0 as a kind of a placeholder. And then multiplying by 4, I've got 4 times 8 is 32. So I write the 32, I'm carrying a 3. 4 times 1 is 4, plus 3 more is 7. And 4 times 5 is 20. Now I'm ready to add these numbers up. 6 plus 0 is 6. 2 plus 2 is 4. 6 plus 7 is 13, so that's a 3, and carrying a 1. 1 plus 3 is 4, and then I've just got a 2. And now I've got to put the decimal point in. What I'm going to do is count how many decimal places there are in each of the numbers that I was multiplying with. So in the 5.18, after the decimal point, I go out 2 more decimal places to the right. So that's 2 places. And then the other number, 4.7, I go out 1 decimal place to the right. So that's a total of 3 decimal places. What that means is that starting from the right of my answer and moving to the left, I'm going to count 1, 2, 3 decimal places and put my decimal point in. So I'm going to have as many decimal places in the answer as the total number of decimal places I had in the two numbers I was multiplying. And now my answer is 24.346. And as a kind of a reality check, we can look at the two numbers I was multiplying. Well, I could take 5.18 and round that to 5. I could take 4.7 and round that up to 5. And 5 times 5 is 25. And the answer I got, 24.346, is very close to 25. So the answer makes sense. Okay? So basically, you're going to take your problem, set it up as a multiplication problem. Don't worry about the decimal points while you're doing the multiplication. At the very end, count how many decimal places you had total in the two numbers you were multiplying. And that's how many decimal places you'll have in your answer. Okay? That's all there is to it. Take care, and I'll see you next time.